Hi everyone, this is Albert from the Center for High Performance Computing at the University of Utah, and today we'll be talking about some Slurm basics. The first question is, what is Slurm? Slurm is the job scheduler that we use at chpc to provide access to the compute nodes on the chpc HPC clusters. This is how you access the batch system so that you can queue up jobs. This is how you access the compute nodes directly through interactive sessions. In order to interface with the compute nodes, you have to go through Slurm. And so there are a bunch of things that you need to learn about Slurm so that you can understand how to use them. The first thing to understand about Slurm is the concept of accounts and partitions. An account is obviously an access group which gives you access to different resources on the cluster, but the concept of a partition is a logical unit which breaks up the cluster into different usable units based on the qualities or traits of different nodes. Now, the setup of partitions varies between different computing environments, but at chpc we have basically four partitions that we use on our main allocated clusters, which are King's Peak and Ember. So for allocated use, the partitions are simply King's Peak and Ember. So if you are in a user group that has access to allocation, this is the partition that you will primarily use. Now, if you run out of allocation or you don't have any allocation, then instead you use the free cycle partition, which is King's Peak free cycle or Ember free cycle. Now, some groups also have private nodes which are reserved for their exclusive use. And to access those, you use the group name, which in our example here is Baggins, followed by the -kp or -em, depending on it, King's Peak or Ember. So those are for owner nodes. And as a user, you also have access to the owner guest partition, which is King's Peak guest and Ember guest, which allows you to run on the owner nodes in a guest fashion where your jobs are preemptible. The accounts are very straightforward. If you are using allocated or free cycle, it's simply what your PI name is, your principal investigator. In this case, our example is Baggins. If you're using the owner nodes, then it's the exact same name as the partition, so Baggins KP partition is also Baggins KP account. For the owner guest node partition, you simply use owner guest as your account. So here we have some examples of how you would use this. You use --account equals Baggins, --partition equals Ember. And we'll see how that works in a little bit. Now we also have two other clusters, which are simply free cycle clusters, Lone Peak and Tangent. They only have one partition each, Lone Peak and Tangent. You use your standard account name for that. These are non-preemptible clusters, but quick availability is not guaranteed. It's kind of a first-come, first-serve within reason. You should also know that Tangent is an experimental cloud-based server, so launching your jobs can be a little bit weird. And here's an example of how you would set up your account and partition for those as well. In Slurm, there are a few basic commands that you need to know in order to launch jobs, cancel jobs, and see what the state of running jobs are. And so we're going to go through those really quickly. The most basic command, and the one that you'll want to know first, is sq, which is simply type so. SQ shows a list of all the running jobs in the cluster at a given time. Now you can imagine that this would be only sort of useful because you don't want to see all of the jobs that are running. You're really only interested in your jobs. And so the easy command for that is to use sq-u followed by your username. So if I put my username here for the test account, you can see that it gives me not a whole lot of information, and that's because I don't have any jobs running. Now the information that this gives you is the job ID, the partition that you're using, the name, your user, the state of the job, how long that job has been running, the nodes that are being used, and then number of nodes, excuse me, and then the node list of those nodes. And so you can imagine that this is useful to us because it gives us some information about whether or not things are running. Now, let's say that you want to look at all of the accounts for your group. You can actually also use the flag account, like so, And let's say I wanted to check out owner guest, for example. Now there are quite a few jobs running here, but you can see that I can see jobs that are specifically in the SQ or the owner guest account running right now, which is nice. You can also do the same thing for a partition if you want. So you can do SQ dash U. Partition equals, let's say we wanted to do King's Peak guest, for example. Now this is going to give me the same output as the previous command, but you can see that this is actually also very useful if you want to look at a specific partition. So another useful command is sinfo, and what sinfo shows is the status of different partitions. And you can see here that we have the basic partitions for King's Peak listed at the top. And you'll see here that we have King's Peak, which has a time limit of 3 days, 48 nodes. The state of this particular list of nodes is allocated, and this right here shows the list of nodes that are allocated. Now, down here we have the King's Peak guest partitions, and you can see that there are four different states right now. There's maint, which is maintenance, alloc, which is allocated, drain, which are nodes that are not being used right now or are cleaning up, and then allocated. We also have here idle, which is the one that you're going to be most interested in. So when you see a partition name with idle next to it, then you can see how many nodes are available at a given time. And right now we can see that there are 6 nodes available on King's Peak guest for allocation. So those are the ones that we'll probably wind up using today for our example. Now we have some aliases which you can find on our website and under the Slurm software page, which I'll show you here in my aliases file, which are aliases for extra commands of sinfo and sq that might be useful to you. So these are the commands right here, and you can find them and add them to your aliases file at our website. But what they do is give different information. So si, for example, gives a little bit more information than simply just the partition information for sinfo. So this shows different nodes in their state. The one that's going to be interesting for you as a user is this one right here, which is the socket count, the core count, and the thread count. And you can see here that we have two different classes on King's Peak, for example, where we have 2-socket 8-core and 2-socket 10-core nodes, which comes out to be our 16 and 20 core nodes that are available to you. You can see that there are also features available to you that you can use directives to access. This also shows the list of nodes which have those features, so you can put together node lists that can specifically request nodes if you want. You can also see how much memory, this is the number of megabytes on the node. You can see that most of our nodes have the standard 64 gigabytes. We have some nodes that have 384 gigabytes available to you. This also shows the number space of the temp disk on each of those nodes, but that's neither here nor there. SI2, down here at the bottom, also shows additional information in a different format, which again is just another view of looking at this. Now SQ gives much more detailed information about jobs that are running, and so if you want to see who's running in terms of account names and groups and other things as well as priority, then you can use SQ to see that information. Although generally I find that the standard SQ, as in SQUEUE, is a little bit more straightforward. Now the next three commands are the ones that you'll be most interested in. These are the three commands that you use to launch and cancel jobs. So the first command is srun. Srun is the command that you use to launch an interactive job on chpc systems. I won't show you this right now, I'll show it in another tutorial, but you should know that you use srun to launch your interactive jobs. The next one is sbatch. Now sbatch is the one that you use to launch batch scripts to be queued up for later work. Now, in this directory, I have an example script, run QE, which runs Quantum Espresso for me, and so I'll show you how to do this launch. You simply type in sbatch followed by your script name. So you do sbatch run QE.slurm in this instance. And if your script is set up correctly, then you will get a message like this, submitted batch job. Now, if it's not set up correctly, Slurm is pretty good about telling you whether or not you did a good job. So if we do sq-u followed by my username, you can see that I have a job in the queue now. And so this is the job ID. We can tell that it's running on King's Peak partition. It's actually running on King's Peak guest. This is the name of the job, which is kind of cut off. Here's my username. This tells me the state of the job, so different states that you will see. You will see PD for pending, you'll see R for running, and you'll see CG for canceling job. Now there are a few other states that you could see, but for the most part you won't see this. Time shows the time that this has been running, so when I executed this command, I've been running for 1 minute. This tells me how many nodes I'm using, and then this tells me the nodes that I am running on. So if we do it again, we see that I've run up to 46 seconds, and if we wait a little bit here, we'll see that it'll run out for me for a second. So you can see here now that I've got this job in a canceling job state, so this means that my job is exiting. So if I run my sq command one more time, you see that my job is no longer in the queue. And so this is what you'll expect to see for a job that runs to completion. If you have problems with your job script, then you might see it end much more quickly, and that could be bad for you, but it's something that you will learn to work through. Now let's say that I wanted to cancel a job. So if I launch my job here again, we have the job submitted again, and if we run our sq, we see our job. So if I want to cancel this, I simply do scancel, followed by the job ID, which is over here. So we do 455453. And if we look at sq, we see that our job is gone. Now this is a hard termination of your job, so if you're in the middle of doing something, whatever is happening during that job is going to be utterly cut off. So if you are using scancel, be careful to make sure that you are deleting the right job, especially if you have multiple jobs running at the same time. So be very careful with scancel, otherwise you can lose work. The last command that I want to show you is a command to show you your job number or job information. So if I do sq again, we see that my job is running. If I want to see some more detailed information about this job, then you do this command scontrol show job followed by the job number. So some interesting things in here that you'll want to know about. So this here shows your runtime, your submit time, and your eligible time. Now the start time and the end time when you're running your job shows exactly when the job is going to start and when it's going to end. However, it can also show an estimate, but you should be careful about the estimate, and whether or not it gives you a good estimate is not guaranteed. Some other things that are useful is this shows you where your standard error is being written to, your standard output is being written to, and what command you used, or the location of the script that you're using. So if you're confused about what your job is doing, then you can use this command to show you information about your job. And with that, that's everything I have to show you in this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you have any questions, please contact us at chgc via email through our issue system, which is issues@chgc.utah.edu. You can also come and visit our offices at INSCC 405. Thanks.